1 cup warm water. And we have to active this yeast. Even though this is already active yeast or instant yeast, we should to do this step again. So warm water, and we put together the 2 tablespoons of yeast, and we put sugar together on this. Stir. And after you stir, you just leave it until become bubbly. You see it? After I leave it 5 minutes only, this one become a bubble, bubbly like this. Maybe 5 minutes, just leave it because the water is warm. And after this, you see it? I just put it the thick of part of coconut milk from the top and put it in this measuring cup, quarter. So we try to put on the microwave, make it the coconut look warm, just light warm. After I put in the microwave for 15 seconds, just warm, and put it inside the bowl. And we put all the ingredients just left behind. 2 tablespoons of canola oil. Egg. Salt. And we start from 1 cup of flour. And now we move to mixer. We have 2 different mixer. This is the small mixer we use it. We're using the hook attachment. Lock. And we start medium speed. And now we can start adding more flour. You don't have to turn off the machine. Just 1 cup. And you put high speed. Until they blend together, put more flour. You can always turn it off and put it another. This is 4 and a half cup of flour. You know what the dough hook attachment for? Instead our hand, you can using this machine, so you don't have to touch it, this dough, with your hands. This mixer doing everything. Knead the bread. You see? They need it, they're kneading. You see it? The machine moving the table, but it's gonna be okay. It's only folding table. We added more flour. Open the lock. You see the flour is still like 1/2 cup left. Lock the of the side of the mixer. Let them keep kneading on the low speed. If you have a big mixer like this, it will be nice. This is 7 or 6 quart professional KitchenAid mixer, heavy duty one. But this is only, it's okay, because we have a small batch only. So you see, the hook knead the bread, so you don't have to use your hand to knead it. You see, everything, the dough is not stick on the bowl anymore, and I'm not even finished the flour. This is 4½ cup. So let them kneading, let the machine kneading more. Keep knowing that instead our hand, is the machine do the work. This is the one we need. The dough is not stick on the bowl anymore. Keep kneading for 5 more minutes. I'm gonna stop and show you. You see? It's not stick no more from the bowl. So we just touch it, still stick on the hand. So we added the rest of the flour. Don't forget lock the machine when added more. While they knead it, we added more flour. And put more speed a bit. And they're gonna put together again like before. They're gonna knead all together and become a ball. Maybe only, what speed is this? Number two speed. Look like the machine getting heavy, right? To knead it, but it's okay. That's the way they make it for this machine. If you're using another machine, maybe it's not gonna be good. But KitchenAid heavy duty mixer, they do the job instead of your hand. They do kneading for you. Okay, we're gonna look one more time. We open, you see, it's a form, it's not stick in the machine no more, I mean in the bowl, but we still need more kneading. So let them do the work, the machine, don't forget lock, maybe 5 more minutes, until the skin, the bread looks shiny texture. Only this stage speed, you don't have to move more speed, 1 or 2 speed. You can see it, the dough texture starting become little shinier than before. Okay, see, it's different texture than before. Now it's like wider and smooth and no more stick on your hand. So you can give me 2 more minutes, let them knead it more, longer knead more better. If you can continue with your hands on your countertop kitchen, put a little flour, it's good to do it, no problem. But I don't want to use it with my hands. Let the machine do the work. So we stop the machine. We open the lock. Okay. And my hand is only one to holding the video. Let's see. Okay, I'll be back. Take it out from the bowl. I'm gonna show you how. You see, right? I just take it out from the dough attachment. I mean hook attachment, and the bowl is clean. And this dough just look like this. Not too soft, not too hard. Okay, you don't need no more knead. And I have a canola spray, butter spray. I spray it on the bowl a little bit, or any oil or butter. I'm gonna use the same bowl to let this dough rest for 1 hour. Okay? Until double volume and all the way to the top of the bowl. We just cover it with clear plastic wrap. You can always using a towel. You put the towel a little bit damp, wet, and cover it. And put it some on the sun. You can put under by the window, or you can put by the heat or by the kitchen. So this weather today is snowing outside. So I'd rather put next to the heat by the kitchen. Little process quick for raise until 1 hour. I show you get back together. I put the dough by the heat with the plastic wrap, and I change with the little towel. Then little wet, but not too wet towel. And look at this, it's half an hour ago, but it's already this much. So wait until full all the way up. Another half an hour, be back. Okay. Time is coming, it's almost hour. And look at this. It's all the way up. That's the way we need it. So now, we start to make it little balls from this. It's up to you how big you want the panada. But I just wanna make it one dough is 30 or 40 pieces. It's not too big and not too small. Now, I'm gonna using the kitchen scissors to make it a portion of this panada. We wash our hands to make it a portion of this panada dough, and we prepare on the table parchment paper like this, and put the flour on the side, maybe your hand stick. And because I have to holding this camera, I cannot do it at the same time. So I'm gonna make it little portion this dough. Let's see how I can do it. So we make a round ball like this until all finish, and we line up everything is right here, the same size like this. All done. I make it all portion circa, total is like 40. It's not gonna be too big, it's not gonna be too small, but 40 pieces. And all finished, nothing left behind. And we leave it raise like 10 minutes. Little bigger than this, and we stuff with the tuna. I will show you how to stuff. We have to let them raise first for 5 or 10 minutes. After we leave this outside for 5-10 minutes, they going bigger size. So about time to stuff with the tuna. Close up this. And the tuna, how to make the tuna, spicy tuna, is on my other video. So as much you want. Like so. And we flip. Pinch together. Pinch all the way. And we leave it one more time, sit right here. And stuff all the dough until finish. And I'm gonna show you the next part. So I feel the panada, the dough with the tuna. So I keep going. I'm gonna keep continue to stuff with the tuna until all done. I'm gonna show you what next. Now everything I already stuffed with the tuna. And you see it? The first thing we stuff the tuna is already going rise up. It's ready to fry. So this here, the last one, still flat. You see it, right? Still flat. But when you see it, the first thing, the first time we stuff this roll, look, it's already bump up. It means they already rise up. To make this panada, we have to take my time, take our time, no rush, because this dough have to be rise 3 times until fry. So we have to be more patient to do this, like you make it the bread. I'm gonna show you how to make it the side for the panada. We have to flip. Be right back. Now we just have to prepare the deep fry oil, any canola oil or vegetable oil, and try to put the paper here to drain the oil. Put in the medium heat, and I'm gonna show you how to start. Okay, now we have to show you how to make it full like empanadas. So first thing is we flat the side again one more time, pinch and go back to the first one like this, pinch harder so they're not gonna open while they're frying. Pinch. All right, one more time. Pinch all the way the side and go back to the first pinch. Fold, 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 pinch. 1, 2, 3.
You put the empanadas in and we're gonna splash some oil on it, and then after that we're gonna flip it. This one too. There you go. Until it grows golden brown.
Here we go. We have to start to make it these things, everything, like before we start over again all the way. And from this side we start to fry medium high heat. You up to you, you like dark brown, but I like just like this. It's perfect for me. Okay, we keep going frying until all done. And I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna open the final result, how they look like inside. Here we go. I open it. Mmm, looks good. Let me try. Mmm, yum. Tuna, a little spicy inside. You can stuff any chocolate if you want. All right, all done. I'm gonna keep going frying, and I hope you guys like it. Keep trying until you get the perfect panada. They call panada, P-A-N-A-D-E. It's totally different than empanadas, but this is like a bread texture. Alright, have a blessed day guys, everyone. Happy baking and keep trying until you really, really love it, what you do. Enjoy!